Thank you. biggest thing that was sticking out is Brett. Okay. Yeah. So I feel like you could stand to be a lot more percussive.
Okay.
Especially like, you know, there's no drums in this group, so like a lot of the vibe and the beat just comes from everybody. You know, you all kind of have, they're different instruments, but they all have this, they're all string instruments, and you're all kind of responsible for being percussionists and drummers at the same time. And I felt like, I mean, especially if you listen to, you know, some of this style of bass playing, I mean, it's not almost all like a little bit more percussive and a little bit more attacked, you know.
Yeah. I mean, you're talking coming through more of that slap feel.
Yeah, I mean, you know, whether or not the slap feel would be cool, but even if you're not doing the slap feel, I still feel like it could be just a little bit more definition of your notes. I'm not saying you have to, like, slap every time, but I just feel like it's, you know, I was noticing what, like, it didn't quite have the rhythmic definition that I thought that it could use maybe a little bit. And then from a comping standpoint between you guys, I love, like, the different rhythms and stuff that you were using. You're holding it, sorry, can you tell me?
Eddie.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, great job, like, holding the sound. But I feel like maybe it would be cool if you could explore some different rhythmic textures, too. Just finding a contrast between doing that. I mean, I think a lot of what's working is that you guys are sticking in the style, and you're, you know, you're not trying to do too much, you're trying to make it feel good, and that's working. But I did feel that, you know, like, you were using some variety without completely like going off the wall. And I feel like you could maybe stand to have this a little bit more rhythmic variety. I think that would just, you know, add even more layering to it. And then just thinking, sometimes it started to feel a little bit like two and four heavy what you were doing too, instead of like, you know, it just felt a little over accented. And a lot of this stuff like comes from the two feel, right?
Yeah.
So if anything, it's like, one and three are super important too. So it starts to get a little bit wonky if you're getting overly two and four oriented. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So those are just little things though, but like, you guys play great, you play well together, and I really enjoy it. I'm sure you guys have some good stories. Thank you.
Trying to salvage some of the low end, because it doesn't on some of those lower ones don't translate through, but probably should have cut back a lot more on it.
Yeah, I would have just in the situation.
Thanks, please.
Yeah, I know, like, it's like too chuck, get too much chuck in the room.
I don't know why, but I
more clarity. I know it's rough. You gotta just sort of jump on stage and do your thing. For that, I really commend all of you. But I think, like, dynamically, there were some really nice moments, but there's always more that you can do. And on Karen, I kind of wished you would play the melody the whole time, but, you know, that's sort of your jurisdiction. And it was you did something really musical on the last A section, I believe, on the head going in. You started, like, kind of strumming that one note, and it just immediately, like, grabbed my attention. That's really cool. So however you can do that to shape, like, the rest of the melody is just fantastic. Because when you were playing, when you're soloing on the bridge, I was kind of losing your sound a little bit. And I think if you had just continued to play the melody over the rest of the guys, it would have stuck out a bit more. But that was really the one thing that was apparent to me. But you guys play so nicely together, great time. Great feel, and yeah, I wanted to go outside and party, so.